Welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about the idea of data normalization, aka the transition from raw data to more normalized form, so we can better use it when we're talking about working with databases. As you can see right here, we have a process listed across the board that addresses the concept of normalization. We're going to talk about a couple of those levels really fast and go over the basics of what we're looking for when we're talking about that, so we can see what we have to do when we're talking about normalization. When we first get a set of data, it's known as raw format. It's just simply there can be blanks in there, there can be duplicate rows, duplicate columns, and extra information. It's simply just the collection of data that you actually are starting with before you do anything. Now, this can be even in a non-digital format. It could be piles of paper, theoretically, because sometimes actually businesses and entities that are working with or need to use a database do not have an actual electronic format you're starting off with. And that's what we're going to be starting off with, just the raw whatever you're doing. And you want to get that into a nice, at least preferably a spreadsheet form so you can get started with that, or at least even a form on a digital document, say for example Word or Notepad, so you can start with looking at what are the pieces of that. Once you then have that raw data, we want to turn it into the 1NF, or the first normal form. And to transition to first normal form, what we're looking for is we've got two major tasks ahead of us. We have to make sure we have atomic data. Atomic data means we have for every row column intersection, so for every row we have a single entry that we're working with when we're talking about our database, even at the 1NF form, one row represents one single value for the entire data set. And then every column represents exactly one value. So it's a field or a data member, something describes that actual thing that we're talking about for that entire row worth of information. And so atomic data means that we're filling that up so that every cell has exactly one value inside it. The next thing we're looking for is we want to make sure we don't have any repeating groups. So if I have column A and column Z that have the same exact information going down, boom, 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 line for line, row for row, boom, 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 it's all the same information, that's what's known as a repeating group. So it's basically that one of those information, one of those columns are completely extraneous. And so what do you want to do? We want to nuke it, get rid of that extra column. And so when we're talking about working with a database, get that little thing to stick on there. When we're talking about working the database, we want to make sure we have atomic data and no repeating groups. And that's the first step of taking raw data and giving it to a first normalized form. And at that level, at the very least, what we can do is if we're looking and say working with like Excel or Google Sheets or some other spreadsheet program, I can use the magic power of just filter, like click on that little filter button, and I can see, here's the basic information I can see about what's inside it. Not the best for searching or doing complex questions on, but I can at least search through the data. And so 1NF is basically good spreadsheet form. That's what we're looking for. The next thing we're looking for at that same level is making sure we don't have any duplicate rows. And so you can see that really well, especially if you use that filter feature, because like, if it's the same thing all the way across, obviously we don't need that. And so duplicate rows, because databases, a good database that is, has no duplicate rows. And so if you see any duplicate rows as a whole, slice those out as well. So no repeating groups, atomic data, and if there's any duplicate rows, we want to make sure we nuke them. Then we switch over to the next level, which is 2NF, or second normal form. When we're talking second normal form, we guarantee already that we already have achieved first normal form. So we've already put it in, so we have atomic data, we have no repeating groups, it's a nice table system, a single flat file structure. However, we're going to do the next step on that is we're going to remove any partial dependencies. We're going to actually look at the thing in this table right here relates directly to it. And so when we're talking about that, that means what we're making really is we're making different tables worth of information. I have a table of customer information. I have a table of zombie head information. I have a table of pencil sharpener information. And so when I'm talking about this, I say that giant, huge single thing where it had lots of information, a lot of it didn't relate to everything else, and I split it up into compartments that represent the table information it needs to work with. And so this basically means at this point, 2NF, I'm having two or more tables. That's one of the key things we're looking for specifically. Also, the 2NF, we have some duplication removed. When we talk about going to atomic data, we add extra rows when we atomicize data because we have to take that multi-column values and get into multiple rows for that. And so we get rid of some of that duplication at this point. The next thing we have is when we're talking about 2NF, we've identified some of the keys that we should be using for our primary key. We've got candidate keys, as it were. And so we can say, this is something that can determine information. And so we identify that partial information. We can figure out what is the best key. How can we best organize this when we're talking about searching this? And so if we're using natural keys, we can identify what those natural keys are or what we should be using if we have something already as a good synthetic key, a good numeric value we can use to identify those. Finally, this next step after that is going to third normal form, or 3NF. Again, just like above, if we're in third normal form, we can guarantee we've already achieved everything in 1NF and in 2NF because it's 2NF guaranteed. And here's where we remove the transitive dependencies. And so what we're doing right here is we're going through and we're talking about working with the database. We've taken all these piles out and there's nothing that this declares this declares this. This is where we have the idea, we're using explicitly the idea, we have our primary and our foreign keys. And instead of referencing an entire pile of chunk, We simply use the magic power of a foreign key. So this foreign key right here references another entire row in a table. And so I can have that reference to the foreign key inside my table, which I can have that reference across that. And so I can show those relationships appropriately inside my database. And we'll see a lot with this when we start asking questions and working with databases, but that's the key thing right there. In each table, every entry, all columns are directly connected to the key. And so that, like, everything we're looking at like here, so the key for that table, for each row, every value inside that links directly back to that. So it makes sense. There's a direct relationship of the concepts that are attached inside that table to the single key itself. And then any foreign keys that exist in that link back to another table, where again, each of those values in that, that becomes a primary key at that point, reflect all the rows that go, all the columns that go with that single value for that. And also at this point, there's definitely no unnecessary duplication. Because we've condensed everything down to that single primary foreign key relationship, I can take out that whole chunk of information, reference it with just a single foreign key entry, and that links it back over from that database. And we can see this when we're looking at the visualization of a schema or seeing how we can show those connections between that. But we have no unnecessary duplication at this point because we have a good, clean, and searchable structure. We'll talk more about how this third normal form works with data itself and how we can see this by using some examples of that. But this is just a quick introduction of the idea of the structure and how we can take data and normalize it and get the information ready to have that happen. And so that's what we're doing for idea of working with normalizing data. Take a look at your data set examples and how you can actually break them down in from first into going to atomic data and split into a single table with no dupes or retaining columns. Then we split to second normal form where we add in the, we put piles in there or AK tables of there or the different things and try and make or identify the candidate keys. And finally, we get to third normal form. We resolve all of the dependencies and we have no unnecessary duplication because the relationships between the data has been clearly identified. We can move on and have a great time. That's what we're doing for normalization. Thanks again. Have a good day. Cheers.